All right, everyone, using the same method, I want you to figure out what the structure of this one should be, how many corresponding salts it has, and whether they are acid salts or normal salts. Pause the video and try it first. Next, let's look closely. Same thing, write the phosphorus in the middle, then write the oxygens around it. There are three oxygens in total. At this point, we'll find it still doesn't satisfy the five bond requirement. What do? We write one of them as a double bond. Now, if I write this one as a double bond too, then there are three hydrogens. So where do the hydrogens go? We can put one hydrogen here. But these two already have two bonds, so we can't add any more hydrogens. Does this mean this way of writing it is okay? No, so the two swords here need to be removed. After removing them, I can put a Ching sword on top. But since there are four Linkai swords, what should I do with the Ching sword? I'll put it here, and that way we'll have five pieces. Therefore, we can see that it has two hydroxyl groups, making it a diacetic acid. So in its corresponding salt, one of the hydrogen atoms in one of the hydroxyl groups has been replaced by sodium, leaving it with another hydroxyl group that can continue to react with the test, thus making it our tetraacetic acid salt. If we continue with this, it's equivalent to replacing two hydrogen atoms with sodium, and at this point, there are no hydroxyl groups. Therefore, although there is hydrogen in it, it cannot be used to testify against the prosecution. It can only be considered testimony. Can we write about other salts? That's all. Okay, let's use the same method here. Write the zero in the middle or around it. Now, if we write double keys, there are already four items, so I can only put one more at most. To clarify, since there's an oxygen atom here, it can't be written as a double bond. A hydrogen atom needs to be placed here. There's another hydrogen atom written here, and we can see it only has one hydroxyl group. Therefore, it's a primary acid. Therefore, the salt he refers to is ours. Sodium tetraphosphate. At this point, we'll find that the rescue device has been replaced with sodium, leaving only the two hydrogen atoms. These two hydrogen atoms cannot react with the test results, hence the name proof salt. Remember this, my friends. To determine if it's a polyacid, you don't look at the number of hydrogen atoms, but rather the number of hydroxyl groups. To determine if it's an acid or a salt, you don't look at whether it has hydrogen atoms, but whether it can continue to react with the test results. Does it contain hydroxyl groups? If it does, then it's an acid, and if it doesn't, then it's a salt. So how do you determine if it's a protoacid? There are a few simple methods. Subtract 1, and the remaining number indicates the protoacid category, or look at the number of hydroxyl groups. But does having three hydroxyl groups